WWE Fast Lane was the largely forgettable show that I envisioned it was going to be. And right now, the way things are shaping up, WrestleMania 31 most certainly looks like, to me at least, that it's going to be a forgettable show. I was hoping at least with this week's Raw that the WWE was going to prove me at least a little wrong, get me a little hopeful that they'll be able to pull out a really good show come the end of March with WrestleMania 31. Instead, they frankly gave me a largely forgettable Raw to follow up on a largely forgettable pay-per-view. I'm still trying to figure out why the hell the WWE thinks it's a good idea to do this type of crap to their Intercontinental Champion. Why would you put the strap on Wade Barrett just to make him look bad at every possible turn? Why would you put the strap on Wade Barrett to make him look like anything other than a viable, credible, legitimate Intercontinental Champion? I don't get it. Like, here he's facing off against Dolph Ziggler. Why is he wrestling Dolph Ziggler and losing? Why is R-Truth doing commentary? Why are they doing this shit with the Intercontinental title? Now they're talking about doing some freaking ladder match for this belt at WrestleMania. Hey, WWE, you might be able to spot-fest your way into fooling some of these other knuckleheads, but you're not going to do it with me. This is fucking stupid, period. And if you're going to do a ladder match at WrestleMania, I've got an idea. How about you do one that's called Money in the Bank? I understand wanting to get your Royal Rumble winner over in every way imaginable, and I understand you wanting to use others to try and get that guy over, especially because he needs it. However, with that said, this Roman Reigns Admiration Society segment was complete and utter bullshit. You've got Paul Heyman basically saying that Roman Reigns is a conqueror of everything that is not Brock Lesnar. The same guy that could barely beat Daniel Bryan at Fastlane now could beat Bruno Sammartino or Hulk Hogan and Andre the Giant. Oh, get the fuck out of here. This is why hardcore fans resent when the WWE gets behind a certain type of performer, a certain type of guy, because of bullshit like this. And I know it most certainly had to be frustrating as they watched as their hero, Daniel Bryan, was going out of his way to do the right thing. And that was put over Roman Reigns in the best way he possibly could. I know that aggravated a lot of you, and I'm most certain that it did with Marcus Smart as well. Holy Jesus Christ, WWE! What's next? It's bad enough that you had our hero, the great one, Daniel Bryan, lose to that no-talent Samoan Roman Reigns at Fastlane, that knockoff test wannabe, but then he's coming out on Raw, and he's asking to put him over like he's the greatest thing since sliced bread. What's next? You're going to ask Daniel Bryan to give him a hand job and a reach around? What's next? You're going to ask Daniel Bryan to insert that Samoan schlong into his glorious goat hole? Excuse me, WWE, but we cannot be silenced this easily. We will not be denied because Daniel Bryan is the best mother of us in the world. I mean, what's next? Are you going to throw him into the IC title match at WrestleMania? This isn't the last you've heard from us, WWE. Swear to God, it's on.
I know a lot of you are upset right now, but you'll get over it. The fact of the matter is, Roman Reigns was the better man, and he proved it at Fastlane, and I personally think it's awesome that Daniel Bryan acknowledges this fact and understands this fact and realizes that Roman Reigns is the future of WWE. He knows he can't fuck with them. If you can't beat him, join him. Hell yeah, bitches. Romans, love yous. Love you, Romans. Commies. See you at WrestleMania's.
What did I tell you? What did I tell you was going to happen? What did I say was going to go on? What did I say? I told you that Cesaro and Kidd as the tag champions and the Usos coming back after them to try and get back their titles was going to end up becoming a thing between Natalya and Naomi, and that was going to be the focus of what went on between these two teams heading into WrestleMania. Well, it looks like we found out what's actually going to happen, and it looks like the Schlig Daddy was right once again. So instead of giving The Miz and Mizdow their own featured WrestleMania program and WrestleMania match that their storyline has justified, necessitates, and frankly deserves, we're going to stick them into a schmoz of 28 other guys in the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal and try to sell that like that's something good. Whoopee! And for all of you that sit there and say maybe that's great because Mizdow will get his big moment and he'll win the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal and that's going to lead to bigger things for him in 2015 as a babyface, how'd that work out for Cesaro last year?
I'm fairly cooked, Axel. But Ryback has to go through you to get to his next stop, which is the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal at WrestleMania. Be quiet, Snow Cone. It's painless time for the cameras. I know a lot of you sit there and want to hate on Ryback, but he's going to win that Battle Royal because Ryback rules. Feed me more. Feed me more.
Speaking of the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal, if they're going to do it again, which it seems like they're going to, then there's only one option. There's only one valid, legitimate choice to have win it. Who's that going to be? Well, that's none other than Mark Henry. Oh, what? A new guy needs to win it? A fresh face needs to win it? You don't like Mark Henry? Well,
if you don't like Mark Henry, fuck you!
So it does indeed look like we're going to get a return match between Stardust and Goldust at WrestleMania 31. It's just a shame that they waited a couple of years too late to do this match at WrestleMania. It's also a shame that they already gave me this match at Fast Lane, and no matter how much they want to, no matter how much they try to get me to care, they've taken one of those things that I should be really excited about, one of those things that I should really be eagerly anticipating, and just kind of has me on the fence about it and not really looking forward to it nearly as much as I thought I was going to. When they talk about C Nation and hustle, loyalty, and respect, they should really just talk about three things. Excuses, excuses, and more excuses, because whenever John Cena loses, there's always some type of bullshit. There's always some type of excuse. There's always some type of reason or justification for why it happened and why it's not such a bad thing. And instead of the WWE going in one direction with Cena and his character in this story heading into WrestleMania, they went down the same old, tired, beaten down, worn out, predictable path they have over the past freaking decade. This is what makes it so hard for fans to get engaged in John Cena and what he does and get invested in him as a character because of bullshit like this. But my hero for the week has to be Rusev. You're damn right, Rusev. Cena didn't win. He lost. It doesn't matter by hook or by crook. A victory is a victory. And since you are the champion and you retain that championship, that means you have no contractual obligations to give Cena a rematch at WrestleMania 31. Nor should you give him a rematch at WrestleMania 31. Run away and hide, Rusev, because I assure you of this. If you face John Cena at WrestleMania 31, you're not going to like the results. Hey, and WWE, fuck you. Fuck you. The Divas match is now back to being our designated piss break. We need a certain amount of time to actually get up off of our fat, lazy asses and go to the pisser and take a piss. By having a 30-second Divas match, that's not going to get the job done. That's not enough time. And I find it hilarious that Give Divas a Chance was a hashtag that was actually trending on Twitter Monday night into Tuesday, and I now just also realize that I have talked more about the Divas in this review then the WWE decided to give the Divas time in their tag match this week. If the WWE doesn't give a fuck about the Divas, why should we? Furthermore, for the WWE, if you are not going to give a fuck about them and this is what you're going to do with them, then why bother having the division at all? I'll have to admit I was a little surprised when I found out the Bushwhackers were going to be inducted into the 2015 WWE Hall of Fame class. I was surprised. Pleasantly so. I popped when I heard this. I don't give a fuck what anybody tries to say. The Bushwhackers were freaking awesome. They were an awesome tag team at an awesome time in both pro wrestling in general and the WWF specifically. Lift my head! Fucking Bushwhackers rule. It's a shame, though, that the Bushwhackers are remembered by a lot of fans strictly for what they did as largely jobbers in the WWF, and they aren't remembered nearly enough for all the great tag team work they did over the years all throughout the territories all around the world. You are not going to sit there and tell me that the Bushwhackers going into this year's Hall of Fame class is a joke, because they've earned it. They deserved it. And that's one speech I can't wait to see on Hall of Fame weekend. The fucking Bushwhackers rule. If you ain't down with that, well, then you can eat shit and lick my head. Now, I'm sure I'm not the only one that, by the time we got to the main event, was frankly kind of sleepwalking through the show, but was a little bit perked up because I was anticipating, and I'm sure a lot of you were as well, that something big was going to happen in this main event. Maybe Brock Lesnar was going to come out and fuck up Roman Reigns. Maybe Orton was finally going to turn on Seth Rollins and the Authority, and you're really launching off into that interesting, compelling storyline heading into WrestleMania 31. We were expecting this to happen. We were expecting that to happen. And instead, this segment just fell flat on its fucking face, and it
did nothing.
Apparently, by this point in time, Brock Lesnar had already left the building for the evening. And you know what? Who the fuck could blame him? And WWE, you get exactly what you deserve. I don't care what the backstory is. I don't care about the bullshit. The simple fact of the matter is, this is the guy that you were just so in love with. This is the guy that you had such a massive raging heart on for, that you had him end the streak of WrestleMania last year. You had him dismantle John Cena. You've had him be this indestructible force. And you have now put the main event of your biggest show of the year in the hands of a guy who has walked out on you before. And we remember how that went at WrestleMania 20, right? So now you're trying to tempt fate again 11 years later with WrestleMania 31 and putting the fate of the main event of your biggest show of the year into the hands of a guy who is not under contract past WrestleMania. This is the type of shit that I would destroy TNA for, and you deserve to be destroyed for this shit too. You're doing all this shit with Lesnar, and you don't even have him locked up under contract long term. You have no guarantees of anything other than the fact at this point in time, you don't know what the fuck is going to happen with your main event at WrestleMania 31. For all the people talking about Roman Reigns, this and that, you're putting it in the hands of Brock Lesnar, a guy who's not great at calling his own matches when this could very well be his last match in a WWE ring. What fucking type of sense does that make? But then what else does type of sense does this fucking make? Now all of a sudden Daniel Bryan and Roman Reigns are not only friends, but they're laughing and joking with each other. Roman Reigns is just fine with Daniel Bryan tagging himself in and getting the victory. And then even more so, this show so badly needed something to happen. And instead of giving us that big memorable finish, and instead of having Randy Orton turn on Seth Rollins, or even better, maybe Seth Rollins and the Authority completely turning on Randy Orton, having this show be one big setup, this ended up being one big screw-up.
If you don't like Randy Orton or what he did on Raw this week, then fuck you. Seth Rollins will soon get his comeuppance. Oh, and it will be glorious when he does. It's true. It's true. Yay. Yay.
This week's Raw was forgettable in large part because of what this show lacked. It lacked big, important, significant, meaningful things happening. In particular, a full face turn by Randy Orton, almost to the point where it makes me wonder if they're maybe positioning Seth Rollins for a face turn and they're trying to swerve all of you, and they're actually going to go back to Randy Orton being heel, or just more so the fact that they don't know what the fuck they're doing. And I'm sorry for those of you that are going to try and spin this in some positive way, that this is, you know, playing it out, and that's okay. No, it's stupid, because this show needed something. This show needed this, and it needed to happen here, and it fucking did it. This was dumb. What the show also lacked was a lot of your top guys that are being involved in major storylines and major matches at WrestleMania. There's no Sting, and frankly, no real follow-up with what happened between Sting and Triple H at Fast Lane. You touched on it briefly, and that was it. There's no Undertaker. You've got Bray Wyatt cutting a very short promo, and that's it. And then you've got no Brock Lesnar. So two of the biggest icons in the history of the business who are going to be in two marquee matches at Mania are nowhere to be seen, and your WWE World Heavyweight Champion is nowhere to be seen. That's a problem. It's a big, significant problem. It's really hard to get interested or invested in what could happen at WrestleMania 31 if it seems like the WWE isn't that interested or invested in. In particular, some of the biggest names and some of the top stars that are going to be featured in some of the most important matches of that show can't seem to be interested or involved enough to bother to show their fucking faces here on Raw. And from what I'm hearing, they might not have Taker fully appear until WrestleMania. Oh, Christ. Buckle up. This is going to be a bumpy road, and you're not going to like what happens at WrestleMania 31, I assure you.